So he says that למחרת הפסח, the day after Pesach, it's when Jesus come back to life, and it's the day when we start the counting of the Omer to receive the Torah. To receive the Torah, it's like it's like to take Jesus to the dimension of physical reality, possibility of fixing physical reality that have to do with the fig tree, etc. Everything we talk about, the possibility to fix this physical world with the Torah that we receive.
It has to do with the second coming.
The second coming. It means it's not above the Torah anymore. Now it starts the counting to receive the Torah that gives the possibility to fix the physical reality. What Jesus calls the fig tree. Okay, so it's interesting, in the same day we start to eat me'avur ha'aretz. It means from the food of the land. And equally in Gematria 614, that this number we talk about this in the past, that it's something that is above all the Torah, one above Taryag Mitzvot, that has equal freedom. Freedom is the mother, the Bina called freedom.
Cherut.
It's like in the 50 years, Bina have to do with the concept of 50 years, 50 gates of understanding, everybody go free. The Yuvel. Equal as Gavor Hamishim Amah, a tree that is a high 50 Amah. That Aman was hang on this tree. Okay, so then in this day we stop to eat the Haman, and we will start to eat the food from Eretz Israel, when the same day when Aman was hanged. On the tree. This was, by the way, we start to talk about the counting because I want to get to the day of Uziyahu. Twenty days after is a celebration of Yom HaAtzmaut. How you say Yom HaAtzmaut in English?
Independence Day
of Medinat Israel. It's in Hey Iyar, the fifth of the month of Iyar.
Okay.
This parallel to the 20 generation from the first man, what is Avraham. The generation of Avraham parallel to the day when we celebrate the establishment of Medinat Israel. In what year? באיזה שנה קמה מדינת ישראל? You don't remember?
48.
Yes. What happened in this year from the creation of the world?
The world.
1948 years from the creation of the world is the year when Avraham born. Another connection to this special day of the independence of Israel. In two ways it's
connected. Counted in the Hebrew calendar.
In the Hebrew calendar, when Avraham born, he was 1948. Not the Hebrew calendar,
Gregorian calendar.
Is 1948 from the time of we counting.
After the count.
But it's interesting that the same date from the creation of the world is the year when born Avraham. In the Hebrew calendar, this is the year of Tashach.
So how
5,708. 708 equal Chen.
And how do you explain this connection between Abraham and Israel?
You don't understand that this,
I understand.
The beginning of Israel start with Abraham.
Yeah,
right. All right, so it's a start.
I want you to explain this for people.
And we have here Chen.
Right.
Tashach equal Chen with a big noon that is 700. Right. This is a Hebrew year. Mm-hmm. This, by the way, we see a fantastic connection between all the special day in this. From Pesach to Chag HaShavuot, to the generation. Lag BaOmer is very important date that we celebrate the Zohar, the Istalkut of Rashbi.
Bar Yochai.
It's the David generation. Is the generation David. It means 33 generation from the first man. David is the 14th generation from Avraham. Okay, so now it's Lag BaOmer. Lag BaOmer. Lag is 33 for the Omer.
Yeah, 33.
In the Koach Iyar, 28 of the month of Iyar, we have the Day of Jerusalem. Lag BaOmer is Yud Chet Iyar.
Maybe it has to do with the age of Yeshua when he finished his mission on earth. He was 33 years old. Same 33. Maybe.
This is a 33 generation is Lag BaOmer. We celebrate the Zohar, the Kabbalah. After the 11th generation from David is 28. This is 18 year, 28, Koach year, 28 year, is the Day of Jerusalem. Who is the king here? Uziyahu. Vayiven Uziyahu migdalim Berushalayim, vayechaskem. It's a song, Hebrew song, that Uziyahu build towel in Jerusalem and he makes them strong. Alright, so, now, this is the generation of the Bible. Now we take the generation of the New Testament. He skipped three generations before Uziyahu. So instead of being the 11 from David, it will be the eighth generation from David, Uziyahu. And we say that all the generation from David to Yoshiyahu to Yeshua are parallel to the 28th chapter of the book of Matthai, of when, and to the 28th time. Right? There are 28 generations from David to Yeshua. And there are 28 chapters in the book of Matthai, and there are 28 times in the book of Kohelet. What is the chapter number 8? We say that Uziyahu is now the 8th number from David. What it is, how starts the chapter number 8? They meet somebody with leprosy. They meet Uziyahu the king. And what is it, 8th time in the book of Kohelet? Time to build.
Kohelet is Ecclesiastes.
Is a time to build. Vayiven Uziyahu built Jerusalem. The Day of Jerusalem, from one side, from another side, when you put it in the 8th generation, still have to do with the concept of building. Building, of course, it's a concept of Bina, of Mazer. Right, so he's a special one in the 41 generation because he's the middle one. It's why we talk a little bit about Uziyahu. Said that the Namek Yeh, we should write it in symmetry. I shall be, who I shall be. We are two Ekiyeh, two shall be. And we can write it in symmetry with the Aleph in the middle. Aleph can be thousand. So then you have big Aleph. And you have five, hey, yud, hey, and again, hey, yud, hey. You can read it a key like this, you can read it a key like this. So then, the gematrias that we receive, if Aleph is thousand, we will receive 1,040. What is 41? Like 41. How much equal 1,040? First of all, 2 times Ekiyeh Shlachani Elechem. Ekiyeh Shlachani Elechem is 10 times Eliyahu. Eliyahu is 52. 10 times Eliyahu is Ekiyeh Shlachani Elechem. The name Ekiyeh, this name appears 3 times. First of all, he say, I shall be who I shall be. And then he say, you will say so to the people of Israel. Ekiyeh, send me to you. Ekiyeh Shlachani Elechem.
So he's a messenger of God.
So this is the part of the appearance of the name Ekiyeh in the Torah, that we say that there are 2 of them. You will not say to them the 2 Ekiyeh. It's too much for them to understand now the 2 Ekiyeh. It's enough you tell them one, but really in this gematria you see that there are 2. If you write in symmetry, you receive 2 times this Namekiyeh. Alright, so it's the same Namekiyeh. 2 times Ekiyeh send me to you equals this number, 1,000.
So even here it's hiding the 2 Ekiyeh. So even here where apparently it's only 1 Ekiyeh, there are 2 Ekiyeh.
Yes.
Yeah.
Altogether the appearance of 3 Ekiyeh there.
It has to do with Eliyahu, you say.
Yes, it's 10 times Eliyahu. Here is 20 times Eliyahu. What else we have with this number? We said that this number is a 41 generation. But equal in Gematria, 42 is. Forty-two people. All right, this expression appears 1 time in the Bible. 42 people. So even we talk about, in one way, from one side we talk about 41, from another side we talk about 2 times Ekiyeh, what is 42. Interesting. We talk about 41 generation, what we say is somebody that have to be count 2 times.
Twice.
It can be David, it can be Uziyahu, like we saw. It's interesting that I try to find this name in a jumping letter in Torah code, and I find it the more short. It's a seven letter.
The shortest.
The shortest appearance of this name, it was in jumping letter of 50. In the place of the story of Yitzhak, Eliezer, the servant of Avram, find the wife for Yitzhak until the meeting of Yitzhak with his wife, etc. So this name appears there. We talk about Yitzhak that is going to get married with Rivka. 50, of course, is a number that have to do with the concept of 50 gates of understanding of the bina of the mother, always have to do with Yitzhak. He saw 100 gates in this year. You know, you remember we talk about this gate and we ask why 100 gates? We know the concept of 50 gates. Right?
Measuring it.
Yitzhak.
It's 50 gates and
it's 100 gates. What is Yitzhak? What is Yitzhak? Is Hatsi Kuf. The same letter, Yitzhak. Yitzhak. Hatsi is half. Kuf is 100. So how much is Yitzhak? 50 gates of understanding. Hatsi, half. Kuf, that equal 100. What is 50? Mm. So how we get to 100? Yitzhak, Yitzhak, Mashiachen, etc. What's the secret of Yimach Shmo? We have one Yitzhak here and we have the two spirit of Yitzhak. We reveal the two spirit of Yitzhak.
So what is the difference between 50 gates of understanding and 100 gates? It's like
the revelation of the two Yitzhak, the two Miriam, the two Mazer from the two sides, the two wings of the snake.
Interesting, yeah.
All right, it is two wings. It's Yitzhak. Jesus talk about 10 alamot. He says the world to come, it's like 10 young lady.
The world to come.
Why 10? Why not 5? The Bina is the Hey of the name of God. Hey equal 5. 5, 50, the same thing. Why 10? Because there are 5 here and 5 here. And 5 are let. Because they are connected to the crown. The crown is revealed in this world like something that is not correct. Always.
Not correct.
Yes. You didn't correct your subconsciousness. Right? You didn't correct what you dream in the night.
Right.
What you dream in the night, it can be a big chaos. It's not yet rectified by you. You can rectify only something that you are conscious of it. What is above consciousness is, it can be a big Pandora box.
Chaos.
Pandora. Tevat Pandora, you know this expression?
Pandora's box.
Yes. Yeah, all kind of snake and devil, and you know, you don't have no idea what is hiding there. Mm-hmm. All right? So, there are 5 that belong to the crown and the belong to the past, and there are 5 that belong to the future. When Chizkiyahu asked from Yeshayahu a sign that he will live, that he will be healed, what was the sign that he gave him? That the sound clock will come back 10 ma'alot, 10 degrees back.
The sound clock.
Mm-hmm. We call the sound clock, the Torah calls this sound clock Achaz.
Sound clock.
Achaz Bashemesh. Connection between Achaz and the sun. The sun is Yoshiyahu.
Grab.
אחז it's meaning grapip, he's inside of him. אחז הוא אחוז. In the sun. אחז. Right? We talk about this, about the snake inside Yishai. It's אחז. This is the way he call the sun clock. And he come back 10 ma'alot. What is the same letter of 10 alamot? 10 young lady. Alamot ma'alot is the same letter. Come back in time. All right, so ego have to do with the time, to come back to the time. If the sun come back 10 degree, it mean you go to the past. But you go to the past for this to alamot, for this 10 alamot, 5 from here and 5 from here.
Alamot is from Alma?
Alma is a virgin, is a young lady, yes.
Mm-hmm. So 10 of them.
There are 10 of them, this is what to come. But the what to come, the what to come is hey. Why 10?
He is 5.
So we talk about two world to come. It's like in godliness and it's like
outside. Manifested.
It's like before the Tzimtzum and after the Tzimtzum. Before the point of symmetry, the wisdom, and after the point of symmetry. Okay?